Welcome to the Sunday night uncensored session of The Slant. This is our YouTube channel, and we like to refer to it as Prosecco and Nuts.
Cheers.
We're a little nuts. We've got a little nuts.
And we like Prosecco.
And we're drinking a little Prosecco. So welcome. This is where we talk award shows. So we're going to talk all about the red carpet, about hair, jewelry, fashion, makeup. Guys, girls, we've got Lucy and Max hanging out somewhere with us.
They're our little co-host here.
Yes.
Hi,
so
guys.
I hope you enjoy our slant on the Emmys tonight. Once again, this is Lena.
Hello,
this
everybody.
Is Liz.
Hi.
I'm BR, and as usual, we're waiting for Drew.
Better late than never. That's He'll right. show up eventually.
That's right. We're going to talk all kinds of shit, good, bad, otherwise, about the Emmys tonight.
And it's totally uncensored, so please, we're going to apologize right now if we say anything to offend anybody, but it is our uncensored version. And what we usually do on our
Are we apologizing
shows,
already?
We're apologizing. I feel like we should after
give you a pre-warning.
Exactly. After all of our other episodes, I think we should apologize in advance. So I'm looking forward to it. Have you guys taken a look at some of the red carpet looks already?
Yeah,
we have. It's been amazing, actually. I can't believe how many bright colors are on the red carpet
this
year.
It's unbelievable.
A lot.
What I find challenging, I think as a stylist, and I don't know what you guys think of this, but choosing a bright color for the red carpet when the carpet is red.
Exactly. I see that so much, especially with the pinks that are on trend right now. A lot of the pinks seem to not quite match the red carpet, and we talked about some of the reds as well too. There's so many different shades and versions of red, and that's also a very popular color as well. And it seems that, you know, stylists have to take a look at that. You know, that same red carpet and what they're putting their celebrities in.
Now, here's a question for you both. Then,
yeah,
would you wear a color on the carpet? Would you stick with classic black? Would you stick with
myself,
white?
Personally, I'm a black girl. I love
like
everything
it.
In black. Yeah,
me too.
Every time I go to a store,
what are they wearing?
Every time I go to a store, does this come in black? And they look at me like, and it's
absolutely
what
Do
I
you know
love.
What? There's a designer in town. He's super cool, super gothic,
Shay.
Real underground. His name is Shay. Shout out to Shay.
Hi, Shay. Oh, I love Shay.
And
I
his
love
line
him too.
Does it come in black?
Yes.
And the
I love
reason
him.
He did that is because all of us who love black, come on, nothing's more chic.
Absolutely.
Nothing's
exactly.
more slim.
It's classy,
exactly.
it's flattering.
Nothing is more appropriate given what do I wear situation.
Exactly. That's right.
It doesn't get boring if it's done well.
And
exactly.
you can accessorize it with any color. Like
exactly.
any color goes with it. So whether
right.
you wear gold or silver
Absolutely.
Or white or red,
or
everything exactly. looks good.
Everything or strawberries.
Like. So speaking of that, I have a question for
yeah.
you. So I was recently attending a wedding and I purchased this beautiful black lace gown. And somebody said to me, black is so inappropriate to wear for a wedding. So I know you're not supposed to wear white. What are your thoughts on wearing black at a wedding?
Do you know what? It's times have changed. Times that are changed. How many bridal parties have black bridesmaids' dresses?
Yes.
Hello?
I think it's so chic. They were black
phenomenal.
I think so too.
Yes.
Yeah, I agree.
I think it's
sexy.
And exactly.
Mine was lace, so I thought it was lace.
Really? It was lace? Talk to us about that.
It was
so strange. Damn, Liz
was
wearing
black
lace.
Lace and
I get
in the appropriate spot.
Yes. yes. Now, my real answer to that question, honestly, is it's really up to the bride and how well you know her.
That's
okay.
very true. Yeah,
so
that's good. Yeah.
I have friends who are all about white, as am I.
Mm-hmm.
I would love people to wear white to a wedding. I think, in fact, an all-white party wedding would be spectacular.
I think
not
so
to mention if you were at the beach or in Miami
or
somewhere.
I think exactly. The place says a lot of it. I think a
it
lot
does.
Of people on the beach do wear the lighter colors.
And if you have a traditional bride, then obviously black or white may not be what she feels great about you showing up in.
Yeah.
However, if she's not so traditional, and I don't think it's a problem to just ask that question. You know what?
So.
I was thinking of wearing a really nice black dress to your wedding.
Yeah.
Good, bad, otherwise, please tell me.
Okay.
I think that's fair. I think it's good.
I think
but
it's great too.
All brides are different, right? It just
I agree.
Depends.
And talk about white on the red carpet. How much have we seen tonight with those beautiful gorgeous yes. chocolate skin tones, and they're coming up in white. And
that's
I
what
love...
she's calling the black girls.
Oh my gosh, just
chocolate skin tones.
But check it out, like
do we match?
Both of
who
them.
Matches this chocolate almond? You?
I think she does better. Oh, she does. You. I love it.
Actually, you know who matches this chocolate almond? Actually, the shape kind of Drew's head.
Oh yeah.
Poor Drew. Wait until he gets
here. Well, if you're late, that's what happens.
That's what you get for being late to Prosecco and nuts.
That's
caution: may contain nuts. Just
so
saying.
This is Tracee Ellis Ross.
I
love her dress.
She has been doing some really amazing things, I think, on the red carpets that she's been on lately. She's been really pulling it together. Mm-hmm. It's amazing. And I think she's been trying to stay a little bit more classical compared to her mother. Who is
Diana Ross out there.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But she's been doing it so beautifully.
And you know, I think that's a really good point because even if you are Diana Ross's daughter, how do you live up to Diana Ross?
Exactly.
Like, that shit's not so going
true.
Down.
No.
So, she has taken a really great grace.
Yes,
and,
I agree.
I mean,
I
she's
agree.
Spectacular.
Yep.
She could totally pull on the full Diana Ross's daughter.
She could pull it for sure.
But I love that she's got slick back pony.
Exactly.
Now, Lena, you were talking about the hair earlier. What are your thoughts on how the hair's been looking
I
on
love
the red
it.
Carpet?
If you look on the red carpet, I would say 90% of the girls on the red carpet tonight, the ladies have the slick back ponytail. It's either parted in the middle, parted to the side. That is
look
gorgeous.
It.
It's
absolutely
so elegant.
Gorgeous. Now, who's our girl here? Who's this gal?
I'm not really sure. She just seems she's from ABC. So
yeah,
really
she's
sure.
the ABC rep, but
yeah.
she's got that
she's
gorgeous
got beautiful
hair.
Yeah, beautiful hair.
I know.
And I think sometimes on the red carpet, a lot of people in the beginning used to try to like outdo one another, and I think less is more.
Yeah.
The less you fuss with your hair, the more simple it looks,
honestly,
the more elegant it looks.
That's right.
Same with the nails. If you look at her nails, everybody's like in the nude nails.
Beautiful.
One nail
I
might
have to
be
say,
like,
I'm not crazy about her earrings with this outfit.
I don't like them at all either. Tassels
so
are not my thing.
I'm glad.
Tassels are not my thing.
Oh, I'm glad you pointed that out. I'm glad you pointed that out. Sorry, I almost had little puppy go
aww.
Down here. Sorry, buddy. Which one is this one?
That's Lucy.
Lucy. Sorry, Lucy.
Lucy's my
oh, my
buddy.
Word. I do think nipple tassels would be fine. However,
earring tassels,
not
so much.
Not so much.
I never liked them. No.
Yeah. No. I just think her dress is very slick and very elegant.
Yes.
And I think the tassels make no sense. There's no sense. They're fabric.
There's no need for that.
Yeah.
I don't really
you know what?
What's
a
happening.
Pearl with her hair like that
oh,
would
yeah.
be gorgeous.
Absolutely.
I agree.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Because we know.
Look at that plunging neckline.
Now,
on that
this
one.
Is Liza. What's her name? Lisa Gibbons?
No. No, that's not her.
Who is
she
this?
She doesn't do TV anymore.
Oh, yeah. See how old I am?
Right.
I'm like, is that Lisa
hello,
Gibbons?
We are.
From 1987? I don't know, but she looks like her. She's like
the fashion police, Tim
young,
Gunn.
Yes,
yeah.
Tim well, Tim
Gunn.
Gunn.
Love to
yeah.
see what Tim has to say about fashion tonight.
He has some really great things to say about
oh, wow.
New York Fashion Week.
Look at that.
Look at that back.
See, simple, slick ponytail. The dress says it all. You don't need to overdo it.
That's right.
She doesn't even have hardly any accessories, tiny little studs.
What do you guys think of all the sequins? I feel like it's
I love it. Sequins. Give me five.
Sequins.
OMG.
OMG is
I
right.
I knew that was going to be their response.
Hello, Hollywood's my nickname. Have
Hollywood.
Heard?
Hollywood.
Anything with sparkle, saying. We bedazzle everything, I think. Be it
yeah.
well as... Yeah, you do, too. I
love the sequins.
Do we love bling?
Especially
do you know how many
on the carpet.
There are the
exactly.
three of us
wearing,
matching bling.
I know. It's just the way it is. Now,
I love
that
it.
White strapless dress was lovely on her.
Oh,
she
yes.
is unbelievable. I am wondering if... If you're going to wear white, what are the guidelines if you're going to wear a white dress on the red carpet?
Be careful what underwear you wear.
Well, let's hope somebody's
like,
got that covered.
That is always like my biggest like pet peeve
yeah.
is when you see the girl wearing the white dress or the white pants and then underneath whatever it is, whether it
yeah.
be the lining or whatever, is just not working for her.
Well, this
yeah.
looks...
I think that's awful.
This one
and
looks
it's
incredible.
Just, well, the material was really great, too. It had a little bit of shimmer and it wasn't too see-through.
Yeah,
I think
yeah, exactly.
a lot of the time, what I've been seeing lately is a lot of white that is very sheer.
Yeah.
And it doesn't really go with the body
flattering.
Type.
Exactly.
No, you have to have a sturdy enough fabric to sort of hold up.
Exactly.
The other thing is she's also wearing strapless.
Yes.
That is a really tough neckline.
100%.
Oh, yeah.
Most people mm-hmm. don't look amazing in strapless. Many people look good,
but
most people don't look spectacular in strapless.
Yeah.
So to go strapless on the red carpet in white,
exactly.
Ooh la la.
You gotta be pretty confident.
Like she's got she's 100%. Brave ass.
And her hair was great too. The way that it was parted and styled, it looked great.
I love that.
The whole ensemble, I think, was great.
Absolutely. No, absolutely. I love it.
Love
I love it.
Yeah, I'm excited to see. The girl from, what is her name? Because I just love her.
I don't know. This is how good
we are. How to Get Away with Murder. What is her name?
Viola Davis.
Viola Davis.
Yes.
Beautiful.
I'm excited. She always pulls out something amazing.
I know.
At every award show. Mm-hmm. And she usually always wins. And I think she's up for a pretty big award tonight as well, too. That whole
See, we don't know all the formalities. Like,
you know what?
Watching.
For me, I swear, I prefer watching the pre-show than watching the whole Emmys.
Yeah,
like,
we'll hear about it tomorrow.
Exactly.
Who the heck won what?
Exactly.
But you know what?
Sit through all the boring speeches. And
we
whatever.
Just want to look at all the fashion and the hair and the makeup.
Pretty much.
So, talk to me about what we've seen for makeup so far. Mm-hmm. Like, what do you guys think?
I love
of the makeup.
So
far?
I think it's beautiful. Everybody loves the natural shimmer glow.
Yes.
Everybody goes and gets their tan on, of course, so that's really important.
Yeah. It's your spray tan, your rub on tan.
Absolutely.
Tan in a can ban. I don't know.
You know what? I'm going to ask you guys. The big trend
just
right
as long
now,
as they don't like Donald Trump tan, then I'm okay with it. Just don't show up orange.
No orange.
As long
wow.
as they're not orange, I'm good. Because
no
it's
orange.
Like, yeah, tangerine mm-hmm. trash. That's not mm-hmm. in right now mm-hmm. at all.
That is not
it's
a color.
It's never in.
That is not a color.
So they usually
skin.
Have like a gorgeous glow and there's just a tiny little bit of shimmer mm-hmm. based on the complexion.
And
natural makeup. You don't see a whole lot of smoky this year on the red carpet,
yes.
I've noticed.
Yeah.
It's a lot more nudes and things like that, which
and
I
shimmer.
Love. And a lot
shimmer.
Of shimmer. I think the gown is kind of speaking for
exactly.
everything else. So yeah.
Oh yeah.
I think it looks amazing.
So I wanted to ask you guys your thoughts on the, because I love this, and I'm sure you guys will too. The glitter lips that's in right now. So Naomi Campbell did it for, what was it? Was it the MTV Awards?
Yeah, yes. I haven't seen it on these ones yet.
No, and I'm hoping
someone's
that we actually
show up.
Somebody else wore it, and I can't remember who. But that seems to be a big trend, and there's actually lip kits for that now. It's a whole process.
Oh,
are you
Lord,
serious?
Yes, it is. I actually
do
saw
you know,
it.
I have
we haven't started that in the salon yet, and I don't know
you
if that's going to be a trend here.
Oh,
or
you
not,
will because I'm going to be coming in for that.
You're going to ask for like glitter lip. Glitter
I'm
going to
tell you though.
That's a lot of work.
I like me some kissing.
I do too.
How am
still,
I making out with lips like that?
I know.
I'm
getting all over him.
How am I making out?
No,
I can't. Make out with glitter on my lip, I'd be like, don't kiss me there.
I'm sure that there's a concealer or something.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't know.
There's no making out
really?
With those lips.
I'm so shocked. I thought you guys would be in with me on this one.
I love the look, don't get me wrong, but I think it'd be better for a costume party as opposed to like an event.
Costume party?
Real life. Oh my
That's
God.
Crazy.
I would.
Really?
I would do myself up as
I would like to try it. I'm not going to lie. But I'm just saying, how do you kiss? How do you make out? Hey, make out.
Okay, tell
makeup,
me what event you
makeup.
Wear it to, Liz.
It's not makeup.
What
makeup?
Would you wear?
I would
you wear?
I would go to Superstore and wear that. I don't know. You're asking the wrong person. I wear the craziest
glitter
things
anywhere.
Just to go to 7-Eleven. So.
I love
right.
it. I love it.
You're asking the wrong person.
Oh, my God. I love a
Let's
man.
Let's talk about
black
the
on black.
Let's
Holy,
talk about
that
the
that is
men's.
Sharp. So Anthony Anderson looks amazing with, I love a guy in a black shirt, black tie, black.
It is. It's so
it's gorgeous.
Striking.
But
it's
you
beautiful.
Know what? Black can be done completely wrong on men because it can look really cheap.
Okay. Tell
Agreed.
Us. Give us some examples.
So Anthony Anderson looks amazing, as Lena said, black mm-hmm. on black. So the black tux, black shirt, black tie. Very monochromatic. Mm-hmm. But if you notice, his suit has some texture to it.
Yes.
It does.
So his suit is not flat black.
Yes.
I find where men make a mistake is they've got the flat black suit mm-hmm. and the flat black shirt mm-hmm. and the flat black tie. So they're very one-dimensional.
I agree. Yes.
And it can look a little on the cheesy side.
No, he's definitely got dimension. That's
you
got to
keep
yeah.
it rich. Now, it's a tuxedo, so the lapels are quite gorgeous.
Sorry about the,
Sorry about the barking, but
oh, gosh.
The dogs, they're watchdogs. You saw how huge
no,
they are.
I mean, somebody's
they
need to say something.
Maybe that's true. They're the welcoming
Hopefully.
Committee.
They're the welcoming committee. Yeah. But he also looks amazing because his skin is dark
Ooh,
and his
look at
beard.
This.
Look at that.
Wow.
That's
so
gorgeous.
We've got some
the
beautiful
African queens.
African
are here.
Queens. Absolutely. Look at that hair.
Wow.
Come on.
Talk about complexion of skin too, like the most flawless skin.
I don't think
beautiful.
I've seen so many black people on a red carpet.
And
what is happening?
Oh my god, Drew's
here. Drew's
here
finally. Better than Drew's ever.
So we're going to stop talking about him.
We're going to stop talking about you now.
Drew, come and sit down. Join our live broadcast.
Yes, cuddle.
And we've got your Prosecco waiting and may contain
does
nuts.
Does my Prosecco have a straw?
No.
No. You can have another drink, too. No.
There's your real Prosecco.
Right there.
Oh.
Your real Prosecco. Oh, my God.
And our welcoming committee.
This is the best part.
I was attacked on the way.
Of course.
Hi, Max.
You know.
They're my guard dogs. Committee. That's why.
They interrupted our whole broadcast because they're, barking away at you, the watchdog.
And we were just talking about men in black suits, so, like, perfect timing for Amanda Sharp to give us
he's wearing brown. How's that?
Brown on brown. So what do you think about
brown
on brown?
Can we talk about the fact that... You guys remember Drew?
Of course.
Absolutely.
Cheers, Drew. Welcome to our first night of
Prosecco and Nuts.
Prosecco and Nuts. What do you think of our Prosecco and Nuts setup?
Yeah, you've missed our...
No, this is like well above and beyond. There's Prosecco and there's nuts and there's popcorn.
Yes.
And there's pastry.
Yes. And cheese.
Yes.
And cheese.
We've got to get a little protein.
Well, somewhere.
With our fat and... Yeah. Oh, it's all good.
So I'm not sure how much content you guys are actually going to get here, but we're going to eat.
We're eating.
Okay, I already take issue with this yellow dress.
Okay.
I take issue.
I don't like it with
is
her
it because she's a redhead?
Her hair color, because she's a redhead.
And her skin's pink.
I'm just saying.
I'm just saying.
Okay, so here's... You see,
she is lovely. Look at the glow in her makeup. Like, she's gorgeous.
She
and
should be like in an
hair.
Emerald
is
green
that dewy
dress.
Makeup
Come on.
Still
Absolutely.
In, Lena?
Yes,
yeah,
it is.
Really.
Yeah. Dewy makeup is still in. But
do you like dewy makeup?
Emerald green would look really.
Yep, we have to, you see, we have to get way to the ground floor before we get to dewy makeup.
All right.
Okay?
All right.
So my question is.
Yeah?
What's dewy makeup?
No.
It's Drew makeup. No, I'm just kidding.
Okay, so it's changed. But the interviewer just now, do we know who that was?
The interviewer?
No, we're terrible. This is a slant. Like, we don't know anything.
No, okay, well, just in case. I mean, but I'm saying that did that lady in the yellow dress
the yellow?
With the pink complexion, did she look pink because she was next to a tanned lady? Like, if she was just on her own in that shot.
No. What is he talking about right now?
I don't know.
No.
I'm saying, like, sometimes, if all of a sudden I were next to, like, really, really light people.
Right.
Would they look really, really light, or me look really, really dark? Whereas if I go next to my dark friends, then I'm the one that looks really, really light.
I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
I think she's just pink.
Okay.
Just going to say it.
She's just
pink. I think the dress was
no,
right for
she,
her.
No, she has a really, like if we want to get technical, she's got a lot of oxyhemoglobin in her skin tone. Oxyhemoglobin.
The word of the day is
oxyhemoglobin. So our skin tones are made up of keratin, oxyhemoglobin, and melanin.
Dewy makeup.
Melanin.
Yeah.
And dewy makeup. And melanin.
Right.
Yes.
So those three combinations of color make up our skin tone. And all of us have different levels of each one.
Mm-hmm.
Her oxyhemoglobin is really high because it gives her a really fair complexion with a little pink undertow. For real. Many Eastern European, like there's a lot of typical countries that have a lot of oxyhemoglobin. Also comes with lighter eyes typically as well. So when you're wearing that yellow color on a really intense fair skin with a lot of pink to it, it's just not her best. I get that that's a gorgeous color and it's a seasonal color. It's in. It is all over.
Yes.
Some form of mustard. You can't go wrong. Except when you're on the red carpet at the Emmys.
Exactly.
Skin is predominantly pink.
I agree.
So that is my technical explanation for all y'all out there.
Oh, that's
my
technical.
I did learn something already today.
See?
There you go. You haven't even been here 5 minutes.
Educational Prosecco and nuts.
Educational.
Really, this is an amazing spread.
Isn't it? This is what happens Sunday night.
We're going nuts tonight. Here we go.
This is amazing.
Yeah. May contain nuts. Allergy alert. For those of you allergic to nuts,
100%
you might want to turn this off.
For those of you allergic to nuts, don't look at this side of the cup.
100% nuts on the table and around the table.
A couple of us here.
So, there we go.
Asshole.
Okay. Well.
Look at you.
What are you going to eat? What do you want to try? What do you want to...
I've clearly missed a bit.
Well, we're going to give you a little more here.
Why don't you have a little something?
So what is this with the straw?
Oh, that's a little non-alcoholic drink if you need to... Take a break.
Yes.
You've got a non-alcoholic option.
Okay.
Just saying. Okay. You don't have to. So we were yummy. Kind of chatting about guys before yes. Drew came in and made his grand entrance.
I'm so sorry.
Which I love. My favorite, I know the gowns are amazing and there's so much to talk about.
Yeah.
The hair, the makeup. But I do think that many award shows and many commentators leave out the guys.
Oh, yeah.
They're like, oh, you look sharp. Who are you wearing? Well, I'm wearing an Armani tux, or I'm wearing, you know, whatever tux. Mm-hmm. But they don't tend to dissect them the way they do women's. And I get it, but
honestly, sometimes, like, a lot of people say, well, what can go wrong with a guy? There's a lot that can go wrong with a guy.
Okay, so help me out.
The cut of pants
from
can go wrong.
From what we've seen so far, mm-hmm. what went wrong with the guys?
Actually, we haven't seen anything bad yet. It's been really nice.
Daytime TV. Well, this is also evening TV, right? The Emmys
But anytime I see someone and I'm like, I clearly have no idea who that is, I'm convinced it's daytime TV.
I gotta tell you, I don't know who that is.
I don't know who that is either. Actually, I was looking at her skin as we were talking
about skin. I don't know her,
skin.
But I know the guy is from The Bachelor. He's the host of The Bachelor.
Yes, he's
the
host of The Bachelor.
Oh, yes, of course. Yeah. Of course. But I do think let's talk some more guy stuff. But I really, really liked how at the Oscars last season, we saw a lot of guys in Navy.
Oh my gosh, me too.
Oh,
yes.
The blue is spectacular.
Yeah.
Actually, I was at an event last night, mm-hmm. and a bunch of the guys were in blue suits, and I was like, am I missing something?
Blue is the new blue. I mean, I was going to say it's the new black, but it isn't, because black's always black.
Yeah.
But blue on blue is a huge mm-hmm. trend.
Yeah.
It's been happening last fall it started.
With the tan shoes and the belt and whatever.
I saw from
yeah,
blue and brown,
do it.
100%. Even if you're sticking to your old gray, throw it on with brown, you'll look fresh and new again. Mm-hmm. So the blue on blue on blue. So blue suit, blue shirt, obviously brown belt, brown shoes,
yeah.
blue tie,
yeah.
different shades of or yeah. patterns, yeah. but it is gorgeous.
It is.
I gotta tell you.
All right, Sterling, that was good. You did well.
Sterling, you did well. I didn't even see you.
Benny, you did well.
Benny, you were hot too.
I didn't say that.
Welcome back to our Sunday night Prosecco and Nuts. It's our uncensored version of the slang.
I'm sorry.
Thank you for tuning in.
Every time we say the name, it just makes me laugh.
Prosecco and Nuts.
So we're eating nuts, we're drinking Prosecco.
And we're checking
out
how gorgeous Viola Davis is. Viola
Davis. I've been waiting for her.
Like I said earlier, I've been waiting for her to come out. And she actually did what we were talking about. She's wearing pink.
Oh, Drew, thank you.
I love that sound.
She's wearing pink on the red carpet.
Like I said, it looks best on that gorgeous chocolate skin tone. Like, look at her lipstick is beautiful. Her dress
is gorgeous.
I love her bob. It's a simple, elegant haircut.
Agreed.
Everything about her looks stunning to me.
To be honest, I don't think this is one of her best outfits. I've seen her rock a red carpet and she's been amazing.
I was just going to say, her hair and makeup is spectacular. I do think, though, I have seen her in more elegant, more... Stop traffic. Start the car!
I know.
Dresses than this.
Yeah.
Although it's beautiful on her.
It is beautiful.
I don't know how I feel about her man and his matching bow tie.
That's not like, I got in a hot pink tie.
I feel like it's a little bit like high school grad.
I know.
Okay, here we go. So here we got a guy. So this is a gentleman from, what's his name?
He always plays like crazy roles.
Mr. Robot.
Oh, that's him?
Yes, it is.
Okay, I like a guy in the white
Rami
suit.
Rami Malek.
He looks amazing in the white.
Is he Arab?
I feel like he's Arab. Why? You need a little break? Should I need a little fan break for your Arab man? Your gorgeous Arab man.
Oh, Liz, you and the Arab man.
She loves her Persians.
He has an identical twin.
Oh, he does?
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Who's not really identical.
Talk about it.
I saw them on one of the late night interviews.
I love it.
So they went off to do completely different studies in college. He obviously mm-hmm. went to the theater.
Right.
He told a really, really funny story. I'll probably see if we can link that YouTube clip to it, actually.
Okay,
where he talked
right.
about
excellent.
He actually impersonated
his brother.
Oh, wow.
That's amazing. Wouldn't you love to do that if you were a twin?
I would do that.
He could have a Mark Anthony vibe going on.
Thank you. I was going to say at first, I thought it was Mark Anthony, and then when we looked together, I was like, oh, no, it's not.
No.
But
those
he just had that similar look.
Similar features.
Yeah,
for sure.
Now, I love his white on white. I do like the velvet tie. It is a little crooked, but he's got time. She should judge that for him. And I like his pocket square.
I don't know.
Checkered.
I don't like this look. It looks
I'm
like
okay.
waiter-ish.
It is a bit waiterish.
There's one of the funniest men that I love.
James Corden.
Okay. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Now we're
going to James Corden. Great blue suit, black lapels. I love these hand-tied bow ties. Like, these are not your clip-ons.
I was going to ask you what you
this
think about these bow ties.
This is good shit. Oh, I love a bow tie.
Yeah, but you have to do it right.
Because one side's bigger than the other. Do you know why?
And it doesn't look...
Do you know why? Because they're actually tied.
They're not tough.
Excuse me, this is the stylist problem. They should be making that look good before they get on camera. I'm sorry. There's no excuse for that.
You're right. But that looks good still. I mean, it is impossible to get both ends even. It is just because of the way you tie it. But he looked sharp.
He always actually really looks good.
He looks sharp for a heavier set guy.
Yep.
He always looks pretty good.
Yeah. His style's super slim. They don't have him in some crazy badass double breasted or something.
Yeah.
Which doesn't work on a guy who's not super thin.
Maybe that button looks like it's ready to give.
Well, you know what? You know what?
Could be just a tad bigger maybe.
And I know that
because when the lapel starts to flip in the back, that's a sign of like, I could have used another inch or two.
Well, you know, maybe he was on a cleanse.
No, it's not like that. I'm saying in the jacket.
Maybe he was on a cleanse and he didn't lose as much weight as he'd hoped.
Maybe, yeah.
I think he looks good. We need to not
criticize. I do think he looks great.
What would you just say?
I say we
what did you just say? We need to not criticize.
Did I say that?
Yeah, you
I
did.
Sat oh down God. And you said this lady with her super hemoglobin was no good in her mustard dress. Did you just change like in 15 minutes? We just changed it.
Yeah, Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde.
So the bow tie is good. The bow tie, this is the third in 5 minutes I've seen. So
because it's formal.
And there's two in the back.
Yes, you're going to see bow ties all night. It's called formal wear. Just saying. It's called formal wear.
See, I want to go, I know you guys hate that I talk about the Trump, but I'm going to just go back for just a minute and look at this guy. Oh my gosh.
Stop for a minute.
Angela Bassett.
Can we talk about mustard being done right?
Yes. Exactly. There it is right there.
Absolutely.
Especially on a hot dog. really, really good. Sorry, I have to get in where I can. I have no idea. Hot dogs, however, I can help you.
I love it. Sorry, I was saying
that gentleman right there, our fashion police,
Yes.
He's got thinning hair. It's all beautiful and white. He's got it slicked back. He looks
great.
Very classy.
He looks great. It's Tim Gunn.
Why the hell can Donald Trump not do that?
Because Tim Gunn is gay. First of all, so
I don't
know
that
exactly
haircut isn't like a gay haircut.
He knows how to put it together.
I think Donald Trump should hire him. Maybe he'll have a chance.
I love this reasoning. Why is it? Well, it's because he's short.
And he's heavy set.
Yeah. No, it's because he was born on Wednesday. He doesn't have nothing to do with anything. It's because he's gay. He knows how to put his hair together because he's gay.
He was born on a Wednesday.
Look at all these older men coming in, and they all have their hair properly done. That guy seriously needs to watch these
Trump,
shows.
He's a fashion Trump, expert. You gotta get your Tim hair is a fashion sorted. Expert. He's not gonna ever come out with hair like Donald Trump ever.
No.
Who's gonna
I'm
hire
saying
him?
Donald no. Trump should be watching this show so you
well,
can get
Well, Donald
a
Trump doesn't watch things.
He doesn't.
Do you realize there's nobody in the world who would come out with hair like Donald Trump?
Nobody!
No!
Oh my
god. Did you guys see that video I sent you guys?
The Jimmy Fallon?
Jimmy Fallon messing with his hair.
Yes,
that was amazing.
I thought it was going to come off. Like,
you thought it was a toupee.
When you're done watching us, YouTube it.
Yes.
It's fantastic.
We'll put the link below, but my God, I seriously thought it was going
to
come off.
Do you know, like, I have to tell
you. Everybody thinks it's a hairpiece. You guys, it's not a hairpiece. It's his actual
He just
corn
grows
on the cob
it.
Hair.
It's the corn husk hair. Corn on the cob hair.
It
He's
is.
Got that hair. But I have to tell you, we were at a family dinner at my in-law's place one Sunday afternoon, and one of the guys has a comb over. One of the older men in the family.
Oh, yeah.
No. He has a comb over.
And I know your family. I'm scared where this is going.
Oh, God.
So my sister-in-law says to him, Gary, what's with your haircut? You know it's all crooked, right? Like, one side's longer than the other. And he's older. And he looks at her and he's like, oh. And he just sort of fixes it up. And she goes, no, but look, like, this is all, like, on the wrong side and stuff. And he's just like, and we're
don't
like,
don't touch me.
We're telling her, stop it. She had no idea it was a comb over.
Oh,
it's a grown ass woman.
God.
Grown ass woman. Didn't know it was. I love
a
you.
Comb-over.
I love you, Mary. You know who you are. But she had no idea it was a comb over. And she called him out on it at dinner.
I'm sure she does not.
With like 22 people. She called him out.
That's something I would do at my family dinner.
I totally would. No,
you would. She called him out.
Oh, are you joking?
He had the dog.
I know what you would do. You would be like, that's a terrible comb over. Pass the cheese.
Pass the cheese.
That's what you would do.
I don't think so.
Honestly,
I'm pretty bad on my family, to be honest. If something doesn't look good.
Yeah, but you would tell them. You would not be like, you would not know it's a comb over.
Oh, no, I would know that.
Yeah, you'd be like,
Uncle,
please cut that comb over.
Yeah. No, I would get out the scissors and the razor and everything and do it right there. Are you joking?
But
I love
how
this is my brother
like several times.
They're
just going at it.
I know, we're just going. He was really embarrassed, and she was like, what? How the hell did I know? And we're like, are you an idiot? Like, she's not an idiot.
Exactly.
But anyway, he's got the Trump going on, but it's brown.
That's funny. I don't know why everything is going back to Donald Trump all the time, but we'll be right back. We're going to take a little break here, and we'll be right back on Prosecco and Nuts.
Yeah.
Stress the
nuts. Welcome back to Sunday Night Prosecco and Nuts. This is the nuts. This is the Prosecco.
Yeah.
We are talking about the red carpet
having
ends
a hard time
tonight.
With the nuts part, I think.
And
I don't know why. You're
what
nuts.
We're seeing on screen right now is Amy Schumer, John Travolta, and I'm thinking
what's
Kelly.
What's his wife's name?
Kelly Preston?
Mm.
Kelly Preston,
yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
Is that her?
Wow,
she looks like Dolly Parton and Kelly Preston had a baby.
Oh my God, Amy Schumer's
what's happening?
Boobs look crooked.
Okay, we've got some issues with Amy Schumer. Her boobs are kind of, her dress
her dress is making
dress.
Her look.
No, do you know what? Her dress is asymmetrical, but we're seeing cleavage on one boob. We got boobage.
Can I interrupt?
The other
yes.
one looks like
I
it's
don't know
completely
what's happening.
Gone. I'm sorry.
Here's the unfortunate thing. If I have something to say, things are going wrong.
Okay.
Okay.
How do you do? What does her neckline look like?
Well, I'm looking
tell
at John Travolta right now.
Oh,
and
God.
That,
don't
those
even
plugs
go there.
Are like terrible.
Yeah, his hair plugs are really
right, and I appreciate that you dyed your eyebrows after the plastic surgery. But I can't even get to what you're wearing right now. This is like,
wow, what is
yeah.
going on with
you? I think he went to his plastic surgery.
What's
and said,
going
can you
on
make me
him?
Look like Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Ah, yes, he's trying to look like Arnold.
Yes,
I don't get the
that's
hair plugs.
That's who I thought it was when I walked in. Exactly.
Wow.
Yes.
And
Amy's,
I don't.
Amy's dress is beautiful. On the, it's a beautiful dress.
I get the asymmetrical, but not
on
a busty.
It's not flattering her on top of, at all.
Not on
no.
a busty gal.
No.
That looks like I cut the dress. Someone said
Drew's
Drew
not
made
a
me
dress
a
cutter.
I don't.
So
I can't do this.
No.
I don't do a one off the shoulder and half
but
a boob out. I like
yeah,
this
it's half a boob out.
Yeah.
And
no
well,
guy
that's
will
pointing right
dress
to
like
nipple.
With
like,
one
nipple's
going to
come.
No, I would try.
I don't like
I
it.
I would try. I would try
Amy
to get
Schumer,
one
Amy Schumer, you're funny as shit, and we love you, but
I
not
her.
That dress.
I follow her on Instagram. She's amazing.
Bad dress. John Travolta, I
her
love your three-piece.
Thing that she just did. Did you just see that on her Instagram?
Yeah.
No.
That was hilarious.
I didn't
she had
see
it on
it.
In comparison to the bird.
Look at her. Oh my gosh. She's rocking that dress.
Oh, she is.
That's
an
odd combination. Why would they put the three of them together?
I don't know.
Can
we talk about John Travolta and Kelly Preston for a quick second?
Is that mustard again? It's mustard.
Okay, so Taraji P.
Henson. Didn't John Travolta come out as
hang on. Before we... Oh, wow.
Am I missing something?
I don't know.
John Travolta? I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Did
he have like a weird massage kind of incident?
Yes.
I had a weird massage incident.
I don't think he came out
as...
Massage. No, I'm not gay.
There's a
baby
right there.
All
so,
right,
Taraji
P. Henson. Let's move on.
Okay, so today I've learned that we need more bow ties, and women of color are definitely rocking mustard.
Yeah, they are. Look
do you know
her.
Why?
I'm learning.
Let me tell you why. Because their level of melanin is higher
oh
than
God,
their oxyhemoglobin.
Look
they're
at
brown.
That.
It's a good thing.
But where was this all the time? Like, is this just a new trend? Maybe it's just because I've not been on the couch with the Prosecco and Nuts before. That I've watched the Emmys and I've never been like, oh, there's an African-American woman and she's wearing that yellow fantastically. Like, I've never said that, but now I'm actually
but you know
from
why
a man's
now.
Perspective, do you not agree that the women in the yellow are looking stunning tonight when they have a beautiful,
yeah, but
darker
I'm,
complexion?
Absolutely, but I'm noticing that Taraji looked like she just got out of the shower.
I want to talk about
nice. That's the
her
big
hair. Yeah,
can
hair.
We talk about the beach salt spray hair?
But you know what?
With
though?
An Emmys gown.
Beach though is in.
Yes.
Beach
on
waves
the red
is
carpet.
In. Yeah.
Stop
yes.
It.
It is. It is.
Is.
Natural.
Stop your lies, Lena. Stop your lies.
Girl, let me tell
stop
you.
Stop your
I know,
lies.
I know. They come out with lying products to give.
Already. Stop your lie.
Okay, no, let, okay.
Not wait. All of us. Not everybody how many likes us, to have.
How many of us here have successful salons? Spas? Yes.
Oh,
yes. So
oh,
I'm, going to defer to your expert opinion.
But these lovely women are our guests in our salon, and everybody has a different look.
That's right.
That they like. So this year, like I was saying, less is more and simple is in. Her hair is that beachy textured look because every hairline we carry has come out with a product to give
for
people that look because it's huge right now. People
now, I
like
love
the
it.
Messy, ugh. Beachy
agreed.
Hair.
I love that.
And
I
on would... the red carpet, you can pull it off if you have the personality. And I think she is the queen of like fierce, and she can pull
she
it off.
She is fierce. I have
I
no
love
doubt.
Her.
Did Kim Kardashian just wear the beachy
she
hair
just did it too for
MTV,
the awards.
Yeah,
and everybody was just like, what
that.
Is
was
she
like,
doing?
I was like, she didn't even take time to get ready. Like,
oh my gosh, Kerry Washington.
Wow.
Baby mama, look at that.
Have you ever seen a pregnant woman so stunning in a black
gown?
Wow. Gorgeous.
She is stunning.
Drew is like,
Drew's
no comments.
Words. No
please
words.
Give me a minute.
My face is saying something else. I'm sorry.
No
give
words.
Give
me some Prosecco.
What was your face saying?
I have no idea. I'd have to look back and see.
We were distracted. Okay.
Kerry
so
Washington is very pregnant.
Kerry Washington is a smoke show.
She is. She's
smoke
gorgeous.
Show.
And
like,
she does pregnant well.
Oh,
there's
so
not a
well.
Lot of people that can do pregnant
come
well.
On. Now like, I'm over the beach carpet. Waves on Taraji. I'm over the beach waves.
Good. Now you got some.
I don't like it on the red carpet. Sorry.
Everybody has a different.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I get
oh my
you.
God.
I kind of agree with you on that.
Because her gown is so, and mustard.
I know.
It's about the dress. The hair was too much with
I
that dress. If she
points,
wore black
though, like,
or something
on,
less wow, the beach waves would have been.
I think for the
Emmys, a lot
it's wrong.
Of women.
Like,
though,
I mean, Kim pulled it off on the MTV Awards because that's MTV.
It's edgy.
Whatever.
Yeah. It's edgy.
But the Emmys, I think that's
it's
kind
a
of
more
what my
formal.
Consensus
I get it.
Is.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people are doing things correctly and incorrectly for the Emmys, and I find a lot of incorrect things going on for the Emmys.
Jeffrey Tambor walking through the crowd is all
we're in a generation, you guys, where everything is in.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, like
it
everything
is.
And anything
honestly.
Is in. So
everything and anything
I think if you can
in.
Wear it, rock it. If you can't wear it, like look at Alicia Keys. She's embracing this
oh,
whole new
she's
concept
so
of
makeup.
What women are going to be. No makeup, no hair.
Yeah.
She does it no matter where she goes. It just depends on, I guess,
she
your
wears like absolutely no makeup. No?
Nothing right now. She has decided
not
to
even
just
like just glossy.
No,
lips,
I think
nothing,
she does.
I don't think
no,
so.
I think she does
I don't
a, something. She does. She said she does one product.
Probably like
and
a BB cream
what it was.
Of some
her
sort.
Her husband actually, Swiss Beats, listed it on his Instagram what she does. He said that it's not completely just not no makeup. I don't know why he outed his wife like
I'm
that.
I'm like,
why would you
that?
Out your wife like
not
that?
Not like Swiss Beats would ever watch this, but
yeah.
Let me holler at you for a second. What are you doing?
Why are you out your wife?
Let's talk about things I can't ever do to my wife.
No.
Just go on our YouTube channel and talk about it. Let me tell you what.
Oh, you'd be cut so quick? You would be cut. Yeah. Like in your sleep cut.
Yes. Let me
no
tell you. Let me tell you what she put on her lips this morning. No.
No, you're not doing that.
I can't
all
do
right.
That.
Before we move on, guys, because we got to take a break in a little bit here.
Mm-hmm.
Favorite looks? Do you have any? Let's start with Lena. Favorite look?
Oh gosh, there was a couple on there that I really, really loved. Mostly, I know I'm trying to think of her name. In the beautiful, gorgeous
Bob.
I can't even think
oh
of her
name. Oh my
gosh.
Angela Bassett.
Thank
Angela you very
Bassett.
Much. Angela Bassett's my
I know.
Takes
tonight. Your breath away. You
she
have no
words. She
was
stunning. She was absolutely gorgeous. Love her simple bob. Love the hair. Love the color of her dress. And she's always so well put together.
She
that would have been my favorite.
Again, another smoke show. Your
yeah,
favorite.
I totally agree. I think Kerry Washington did really well too.
Come on.
I was
Drew
waiting
was
to
speechless.
See what she was going to do, being so pregnant. But
wow,
Angela Bassett.
Wow, did she ever
pregnant.
That
because
well,
you can
because
be kind of pregnant.
No, but it's...
I love Liz's responses just for this reason. Because I listen closely just to go, did she really say
did
that?
Did she just say that?
Yeah.
I'm allowed
right.
to say it. We're uncensored.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You're right.
Whatever
you're right.
Yeah. But I was, like I said, I was really waiting to see what Viola Davis was going to wear. I'm a little bit disappointed.
Yeah.
The color still looks beautiful. She always looks beautiful.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think
but
I got to
but not
go
your
with,
favorite.
Yeah, I think I got to say Kerry Washington on
yeah.
this one.
Yeah. What are you thinking?
Well, if you replay about 7 minutes, you'll clearly see that I stopped at Kerry Washington. So there we go, Kerry Washington.
I
go.
Love that she's the look of the night. I love that because she is pregnant, obviously, like quite.
Yeah,
she's
exactly.
not just brand new pregnant.
Yeah.
She's in there. And I love her. I think she's amazing. My pick, I'd like to see more men.
Yeah.
I haven't critiqued enough of the guys.
I agree. There wasn't a whole lot of them on the red carpet.
No. I'd like to pick a guy.
Maybe during the awards.
Okay, so I'm not going to pick my favorite yet, because I want to see what the guys have shown.
Of what you've seen so far.
I do like Anthony Anderson in that black on black.
I actually really like that.
He looks really slick.
Black on black?
Yes. And I like that you said that it was.
It wasn't even blackish.
Well, on that note,
that was smooth.
We're gonna
one of my
take a break.
Shows, by the way.
Thank you so much for tuning in to Prosecco and Nuts.
I hope you don't think we're completely nuts yet.
We are, but we'll be right back. Welcome to Sunday Night Prosecco and Nuts. We're going to watch the opening of the Emmys because Jimmy Kimmel, we have a full expectation he's gonna kill it. These are the nuts. This is the Prosecco. Thank you for joining us.
There's some other nuts on the table.
Okay, when we decided to do this, there was like one kind of nuts on the table. Liz went a little nuts on the nuts today.
Well, okay. Because
she's not.
But I love it. Don't get me wrong.
I'm a set designer. You can't tell somebody.
Prosecco and nuts.
Prosecco and nuts.
All right, enough with the cheetah chatter. We're going to watch the opening of the Emmys live with you, and we're going to give you a true reaction. So let's see what's going on. Let's roll.
All right, Jimmy, you better make me laugh.
Oh,
my God, he's starting with the Bronco.
Oh, my gosh. The OJ Bronco.
There's a bunch of cop cars behind him.
Is the car they have been looking for.
Oh, my gosh. You guys remember that?
Oh, my gosh.
His buddy's
Jamal Warner.
Oh, God, Jamal Warner's driving.
Traffic
telling
me to calm down. The Emmy start in 5 minutes. If I'm late,
they'll
let Tom Bergeron
off.
You understand that?
Oh.
Tom Bergeron.
Everyone likes Tom Bergeron.
Even the dogs don't like this. Okay, calm down.
Oh, come on. And I am not going to be an accomplice to a traffic violation. Fine. You know what? Let me out right here. Just pull over and let me out.
Oh my gosh, he leaves them on the side of the road.
Thanks a lot, Theo.
Shh, puppies.
Theo. I love it.
Theo. He called her Theo.
Theo. Oh, it's our family.
Hobo magician. Oh, smoke bomb!
Oh my gosh!
Phil Dunphy moment. Come on!
This is what I felt like the other day when all these skunks went off in my neighborhood.
Oh my gosh!
Is that that was an 18 van.
Oh my gosh, this is brilliant.
Okay, how much did they pay for that Audi product shot?
Oh my gosh, it's Jim Corden.
James Corden. Look at his jacket.
Okay, if they start singing and
carpool karaoke.
That's my favorite thing that he does.
Oh my god, did you guys see when Jimmy was on James's show the other day and they
they're gonna do it?
They are doing it.
All right,
this
people,
is awesome.
Look at him.
Oh my gosh.
He's like dumbfounded. What are you doing? Oh my gosh.
I have never agreed with Jimmy Kimmel. Oh, there he starts.
He's singing.
Nope.
Woo!
Oh my gosh.
Woo!
I love it. Look at James Corden.
Michelle Obama gets out of this car.
That was wicked.
Oh my gosh.
Michelle Obama was with him was amazing.
I bet you it is. No.
Oh!
Veep! There we go.
Julia Louis-Dreyfus. Oh.
It's the same thing.
It's Jimmy Kimmel.
Huh?
It is such an honor to meet you, Madam President.
Oh, thank you.
You know you're one of three presidents nominated tonight. You, President Underwood, and LBJ.
Oh, LBJ. That was my nickname on my high school schedule.
LBJ! What the hell kind of initials are those anyways?
We're hosting tonight's Academy Awards. It's the Emmys.
It's the Emmys.
No! Nobody likes the Emmys.
Oh, thank you.
Freeman. Morgan Freeman. Oh, okay, no. Yo, is that Jeb Bush? It is.
Oh my god, it is.
That is
Jeb Bush!
Oh my god!
Oh my gosh! What the hell?
I'm between jobs right,
right now.
I can make $12 an hour driving.
That's so terrible.
That is terrible.
Well, good
that
on him to laugh awful. At itself, though. Good on him to
He's
laugh
laughing,
at himself.
He's laughing, yeah, Jeff Bush.
Good on him to laugh at himself.
Lord.
That's crazy.
If you run a positive campaign, the voters ultimately will make the right choice.
Or you'll lie about it because you're Florida.
Jimmy.
Wow.
Just saying. Al Gore.
Everybody wants him out of the car. Poor Jimmy's never going to make it to the show.
Godless Hollywood hippie.
Hollywood hippie. Jeff!
Oh my gosh.
Oh my word. He's like, can I please get to the Emmys? This is brilliant. Brilliant.
Oh heavenly Oprah.
Oprah!
I'll never take a kid's Halloween candy again.
Oh.
Yeah, you do. You do that every year. Wow.
What's this thing? Oh yeah, you're good.
Nice.
Oh my gosh. Khaleesi.
Jimmy, the Dragonfire say Dracarys.
Dracarys.
Oh,
oh
my god,
Ryan Seacrest!
Oh, Ryan Seacrest gets burned!
No!
Burned! Woo!
Nice
yeah,
entrance! That
nice.
Was pretty good!
Jimmy!
Yep, that was good.
He looks good!
Yeah,
he why does he walk like a 4-year-old?
I was about to say the walk.
Why does
took
he walk like a
4-year-old?
I don't get it. He's got no walk. He's got no swag.
All right, so I guess before the show starts, we'll give you the reaction. We're gonna pause now.
Yeah, let's
we'll
pause it out.
All right,
I'll pause it out.
Rye, let's pause.
Okay.
Okay. So, what do you think of that?
Well,
what
we're
we
pausing.
That?
Are we pausing? No.
What do we
uh-oh.
Think of?
Yeah, we're rolling. I know, but what do we think
Sorry.
Of that?
It was okay.
See,
I think it was hilarious.
Really?
Yeah, it was good. I liked all the little pieces.
A little too much Prosecco.
I liked it, but...
I thought it was okay.
Yeah, I thought it was okay.
Okay, it was okay.
I got too much
production
of
values very high.
Yeah.
Cost,
the,
yeah.
Cost was
the
high.
The fact that
sure.
you got, you know,
a
certain
dragon?
People to be... Oh, well, the dragon looked like it was a scene that was actually cut from Game of Thrones.
Yeah,
again,
I think so, too.
And they superimposed
exactly.
it.
Yeah.
But
not
I
that
loved,
I know anything about it, but it looked like it.
I loved the karaoke.
Jeb was the
and
the
Jeb
Bush was
and
the
OJ
one.
Scene. Call
yeah.
him Theo.
I thought it was
that.
Great. I thought it was good, but I mean, I didn't think it was like spectacular.
Showstopper.
Yeah,
I didn't belly bust. Like you didn't see me
nah.
belly bust. You
got, okay.
Yeah,
no.
No, so
me
I, so what do we give that? How many nuts out of five?
Are we recording?
How
this?
Many nuts good. Out of five?
Oh, we are.
I give it.
How many nuts out of five?
Yeah, three nuts
out
of five.
Out of four nuts. We're four
oh
nuts.
Yeah, we're
four
nuts.
We're giving it a 1 out of 4.
I'm giving it like a 1.5.
Come
then.
On.
A what? No.
Yeah.
What are you, the Bulgarian? Like,
listen.
What are
you,
Simon Cowell?
Figure skating judge? Yeah, what is it?
Figure skating
1.5.
Come on, I gotta be a little different.
Okay, why 1.5?
I'm giving
it
a 2 out of 4 nuts. I liked
it.
It
got a pass. Like, I was legitimately entertained. I would not want to change the channel.
Okay, you know what? I think,
I give it a 3.
I'm not
going to
give
it
more than that.
Yeah. 3 out of 4?
Yeah,
that's good.
It's just the people that was with them. What's funny?
I give it a solid walnut and 2 peanuts.
Nice.
Solid.
Sriracha
solid
peanuts.
A solid walnut.
Covered
two,
in chocolate.
Huh? That's a little much.
Yeah.
Oh,
darn it.
That is a little
so we don't know what we thought of it, actually.
It was
obviously,
okay. Okay,
know?
Okay, okay.
No? Okay.
Forget the nut scheme.
Okay.
What is,
I think it was
good?
Okay. It wasn't
okay.
off the top.
You thought
it
was hilarious.
I liked it.
Do you think it was hilarious?
Well, hilarious. I think a lot of things are hilarious.
That's what we love about you.
I do.
She's so bubbly.
That's because I'm full of bubbles.
That's right.
I loved the James Corden piece in the car. That to me was hilarious.
Was
the Wham piece, hilarious. I loved the Bronco at the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
After Jeb, it fell a bit.
Yeah. Dry.
Like, it just fell a bit dry after that. But, yes, the beginning was hilarious.
Okay. I definitely above pass grade for me. It was entertaining. I would not have wanted to change the channel. I was, would
okay.
have definitely looked at it. But, again, I try to consider myself a student of the comedies.
Blah, blah,
so,
blah.
And yourself?
Blah, blah, blah.
It was good. It was funny. I mean, I think I love Jimmy Kimmel. I think I would have expected a little bit more from him.
That's what it is. I would have expected
okay.
more from him.
Okay. You know, I think it was a little bit safe. I mean, he hit like a lot of different shows that were impactful this season, but
and nominated.
And nominated. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what he needed to do. I mean,
I like that you good, said like it was safe.
Yeah, I guess.
The Ryan Seacrest getting torched.
I mean, the stuff
torched,
he does on his show is ridiculous. Like, and some of the stuff
he's
he
way beyond
Guillermo
this.
Through, I think is
Guillermo.
Absolutely.
I love. And
love
where was
that.
Guillermo?
I know. I'm hoping he brings him out.
Well,
I was really
like a Jimmy
hoping.
Kimmel. Guillermo's got to be in it. Okay, I'm calming down.
No. Well, let's say okay.
I
so
was
that,
in the
that
moment.
Was.
I
was
in the moment. You're reacting in the moment. It's totally cool.
So that was the produced portion of his intro. I think there's gonna be a monologue. We'll cut here, and then I guess you can catch us on the next piece where we'll see if his monologue's any funny.
At least you thought his outfit was great. So I mean,
I did, but
he walks like a 4-year-old.
Like, 4-year-old. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Okay.
Welcome to Sunday Night Prosecco and Nuts. Again, these are the nuts. I just want you to understand that this is the Prosecco. My glass is empty. I don't know how this
how
is going to go
happen?
Down.
How did
I don't
that
know
happen?
How it went down. But what we need to talk about right now is Jimmy Kimmel's
monologue.
Yeah. What do you guys think? Liz, what are your thoughts on the monologue?
Wow. Really?
You're harsh.
No, not necessarily.
She's a Kimmel hater. She's hating Kimmel.
I love Jimmy Kimmel. That's the problem.
I know you do.
And
so
I
what's
watch
your
him
deal?
Religiously because he helps me go to sleep every night.
Ooh, well, talk about it.
He's so funny. He bores her to sleep.
No, it's like my ritual. I have to.
Or is he giving
you
a special massage?
I have to see him before I go to sleep because he always gives me a...
What?
Something to laugh about.
You get
what?
A massage? What's happening?
Okay, so what did
so
you not
like?
Like?
I don't know. It was so boring. It was,
really?
Yeah. I didn't like it
okay.
at all.
Okay. Drew?
I'm sorry. Drew, what do you think?
Let's see. I'm trying to think of the major points there. Obviously, he went in on Trump, so he
that's my favorite part.
Okay.
I like that.
Okay, so again, let's take everyone's politics aside.
Okay.
He just made his politics, like, very evident. I mean, obviously,
yes,
he has a relationship with Mark Burnett, the
Burnett.
Producer.
Yeah.
The
yeah.
producer
yeah.
To say that.
That's got to have a lot of confidence.
Right?
Like
and then the camera panned to Mark, but then he's laughing the whole time. Yes.
Yes.
I'm responsible for destroying the world if this... No, so that's the slant that he immediately put on.
You need Men
it,
in Black
right?
to come in and like, chunk.
Right?
So everybody forgets what they just saw.
Exactly.
So I don't know. I think, we've talked about this in, you know, the censored show.
Sure.
Yeah.
Where,
yeah.
of course, Trump and Hillary Clinton are the major talking points. But I don't know. I'm probably saying look for the joke somewhere else in there where it isn't necessarily so polarizing. But I mean, kudos to him for
that. True.
Kudos to him for actually saying
what Drew's doing. This is what happened to me watching the monologue. I'm like,
I feel like he's telling me a bedtime story.
Okay.
What do you think of the monologue? Drew, I'm sorry. I love your ass, but you're killing me right now.
I'll take that one.
Yeah.
I'll have another nut.
Monologue, Lena?
Wasn't really for me either. He's usually funnier. I don't know
he's
what happened.
He's funnier. That's
is that my favorite part? A high
I
spot,
like watching
spot?
His show more than I like watching this.
Yeah. I think he's got restrictions on what he can and can't say, probably.
Well,
isn't he on the same network? Isn't he on the same network?
ABC?
Yeah, but it's a different time slot, though. This
I
is
guess.
Literally happening Sunday, not late.
I guess so.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Good point.
Maybe.
Good point.
Yeah.
I really liked the OJ bits. I thought that was edgy, and I thought, ooh,
mm-hmm.
he's going in.
Yeah.
I thought that was really
and
cool.
That whole cast,
Cuba.
By the way, I'm
yeah.
sorry, but their fashions were all pretty amazing. All of them.
Unbelievable.
The whole cast,
unbelievable.
Great.
Absolutely.
And Marcia Clark was there, like... How
she's
amazing
killer.
Is that?
Like, killer.
And she came out looking amazing.
I'm still upset that you all have no idea who Maggie Smith is.
I don't understand the Maggie Smith shit.
We're
I get that she's
Harry
down
Potter
to
people. Like,
she's
she
down
didn't
to
show. She's never shown up to wait to pick up her awards.
Right.
I asked these guys off camera if they've
oh
ever
God,
seen
no.
Harry Potter. None of them are potheads. No, not one.
No.
None of us are. Well, that's what we thought of the monologue.
Yeah.
I did think parts of it were funny, though. Like, I really liked the OJ stuff, and I thought he was hitting it. I liked the Mark Burnett stuff he was making fun
of
Trump. I love that he said Mark Burnett is responsible for
all of us
knowing Trump and his bullshit and his crazy town.
When all
like,
things.
I love that.
But do we all of them? There's quite a few people in the U.S. who still
believe
he
would
be a fantastic
I'd love to get more people's
opinion
on this.
Because people are idiots. That's why.
I'm not going there. We have some guests
outside.
I'm
going there. We have some guests.
You know what?
We have some guests.
One of my favorite parts actually was the set design. I'm not sure if
you
guys noticed that.
Oh my God!
You guys were empty.
Yes!
And we had to make sure we brought something in.
Don't shake the bottle!
Better not shake it.
Oh my gosh!
Finally dress gay.
Okay, you guys are here. Yeah. Thank you guys.
Our favorite. Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for the invite. Finally,
guys, we've got welcome to Sunil
and Kelly Andrews here.
Bill and Kelly
Andrews.
We brought the nuts too.
The gays brought
you guys are
and the prosecco.
Okay, come on, come on. You brought more nuts.
We brought more nuts. Now we have six nuts in here.
Oh my God. We do.
Six.
You got the coconuts. Now you get the walnuts.
We're here talking about the beach. Talk about the coconuts. You've been working out.
Coconuts.
I've been working out. You know the needles work good. You know.
It's the camera.
No, I'm kidding.
Wow.
Is the camera angle wide enough for those biceps?
Yeah, I don't know.
What is happening?
Drew, how aren't you feeling, buddy? Yeah. I got another man's take on him.
I'm a little intimidated.
Drew's like, I'm official. My glass is empty.
Yes.
You cannot host Prosecco and that's
and you were
Prosecco.
Shaking that bottle, so I'd be really careful.
But this would be great if some fun happened here.
Oh,
but you
my
did.
God.
I feel like Neil shook it like a shake weight.
Yeah.
Well, I saw a little bit of shake weight.
I was just excited to see you. Should I get somebody else to open it? There we go, yeah.
I
was talking about me.
I feel like that was a shake
so
weight.
You guys were actually talking about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Prosecco and all over the place.
Prosecco and all over the place.
All over the place.
So
there
we're
we
talking
go.
About the Emmys. Woo!
Woo!
Oh,
there
good.
We go.
Thank
you. The Emmys.
We're talking about
Emmys.
The Emmys. And right before
right.
you guys came
Thank
in,
you.
I was actually mentioning a part that I can speak about, which is the set design. I don't know if
we
anybody
need glasses
noticed.
Right
yes, I got
we noticed that, but I thought the set design was actually pretty amazing.
It is beautiful,
years.
Actually.
It's
beautiful.
It's absolutely gorgeous.
So I
it
just
looks
wanted to
really
give a
elegant.
Shout out to my team that I usually work
Thank
out
you.
Or work with, and great job.
Yeah,
Thanks.
The set design
it
is gorgeous. It looks
go.
Super
Thank
elegant.
You.
And we were talking about how Jimmy Kimmel looks gorgeous, but he walks like a 40-year-old.
Well, he's lost a lot of weight.
Can you tell him?
He
has
looks
lost
good.
A lot of weight. Now, can we talk about why he walks
yeah.
like a 4-year-old? I don't understand.
He does it all
the
time. Yeah, he does
like,
it.
What is that?
I don't know.
Maybe it's
I don't
a knee
know.
Injury.
Happy feet?
An old know. Football injury.
Not
if I,
oh my God, sorry, Drew.
If I had a
cheers.
Host the Emmys,
thank
I'd be welcome.
Thank you guys for
coming.
Thank
you. Thank
you
so
for
much.
Joining
this
us.
Is great.
Don't cross. It's
okay.
bad for you.
Oh.
There's
oh.
rules to toasting.
Oh,
okay.
God. We got to do this
good
whole
job,
thing.
Kelly.
I have to learn that etiquette too.
Oh my gosh, Drew.
Don't cross.
A lot of
I didn't know that.
You don't want to cross over someone like
you.
I just want to kiss you.
Here, I've given you lessons. Oh my God. He wants to neck. He wants to neck. Now, if she had those bedazzled lips, there'd be no necking.
Mm-hmm.
My point exactly. if you tuned in to a previous Prosecco and Nuts show, you would have seen that.
Okay.
I'm just going to say that if I were to toast Kelly, I would be crossing over Liz, Neil, and of course Drew. So then that's bad juju to all of them. So we don't
juju.
Ever want to do that.
Oh my God, take that away. I don't need any bedside.
So,
all
you do, so if I'm going
to
toast Kelly...
Has
everybody
to
has to come in.
Oh.
So if I go, Kelly, nice
yeah, let's
to
try
see
this
you,
again.
Oh, and
let's
everybody
try
comes
oh.
in.
There we go.
This is the beauty of friends.
I'm just saying, well, this is how Prosecco and Nuts goes down.
Okay, well.
So before we watch the
yes.
Emmys,
yes.
Did you guys catch... any of the red carpet? Or you
we
guys,
got another
we
red
driving.
Carpet
here, you know.
Okay,
we were driving.
You guys are the worst
yeah.
gays.
They're the worst gays.
Yeah.
I
had
to
say
talk
this
about
because
clothing.
These are
wait a
my
second. I was watching NFL
dear,
football today.
Yeah, exactly. These guys are,
you
know are my dearest
best
friends.
Best gays ever.
Best gays ever.
These guys
best
cannot
ever.
Decorate their house.
Yeah, that's true.
That's why they have her. They cannot dress themselves,
they
which is why they have me. I did not do that.
They ever
we're very casual.
I did not do this.
But
just
we
saying.
Did,
so,
we do look good with our clothes
now.
Off.
We do.
They do look good with their clothes off.
Yeah, that's about it. That's
yeah.
good.
This is
unsensitive.
Okay.
Okay.
You guys
might
break
so,
every gay rule, okay?
I know,
yeah.
they do.
They
break
right
all
right
the gay stereotypes.
But we hang out with beautiful women.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
That was almost a hetero line.
Thank
man.
You. Yeah, yeah.
I gotta give you that was well, pretty close.
A lot of people think I am, but
that was pretty
true.
Close.
Okay.
I've used that one.
Yeah,
I have
yeah.
used that one.
So we're gonna just talk about since you guys didn't catch anything.
Okay,
we're gonna
right.
talk about maybe any of our favorite moments.
Absolutely.
Watching,
yeah.
The monologue, the entrance, and the red carpet, and
yeah.
then we're gonna watch the Emmys,
sounds
and
good.
we'll go from there.
Yeah.
All right.
We'll
let's
see
go.
You
guys
soon.
We'll be
back.
We'll be right back.